Ken, Joe? Kalyana, Joe? Okay. Thank you, Mr. Kulkarni, Mr. Dava, and everyone else, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be here. And I don't know Mr. Kulkarni from long, but I've had some interaction with him, and he's been very kind to me, very helpful to me. And thank you for the kind words you just mentioned for my father, my family. And I had made a small request to you day before yesterday, and you were there with the answer, which I'll take back home and study and see how I can use it in the National Assembly of Pakistan. I'd like to have an interactive session more than that's more interesting, but just to introduce, I'm just a new parliamentarian. It's been 2 years with Mia Nawaz Sharif. And a lot needs to be done on the minority front. There's no two opinions about that. But the problem that we are all facing, and I was telling a journalist in the morning also, Times of India, is that the government does seem to realize what we have nurtured over the years. And I would not like to go into the details of what we have nurtured. But today, many things we are working on as a government, but this terrible law and order situation, as we all know, has really taken up time of everyone. The minority problems, unfortunately, are on the back burner. So, me being an MLA, as you call it in Pakistan, an MLA in India, so being just an MLA, that does not just, we need the Prime Minister's support, we need the whole government support to come out with certain bills, which I'm just going to outline and request Mr. Kulkarni to do note these down, what I'm, things I'm trying to work on. But I can't do it alone. So whenever so there are many problems. Most of the debates are centered around the killings, the bombings, the war on terror, as we all know. And lately, for about 7-8 months, we've had this sit-in of Imran Khan. So the government and the Prime Minister, they were just trying to save the government and save the seat, rather than worry about what the issues of minorities are. Even the issues of the majority are neglected. What to talk of minorities? I mean, there have been more bombings in mosques than, God forbid, in temples or churches or anywhere else. So anyway, other than I'll come to my what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to, having said that, whether they're listening or not listening, that is not under my control. But at least it's my right as an MLA to introduce certain bills for minorities. And number one, I'm trying to bring a forced marriage, I'm trying to bring hurdles in the way of forced marriages of young Hindu girls, incest. It's done mostly for lust, and sometimes not for lust, but anyhow, this forced conversion is being done with the poor lot living in Sindh area near the Tharparkar desert. And this, I'm trying to bring two hurdles, for the lack of better word, I'll just use the word hurdle. I'm trying to bring two hurdles. Is one is that you cannot, the girl has to be 18 years of age, number one. And number two, you cannot convert a Hindu girl, or anyone for that matter. It has to be done in the presence of a first class magistrate or a high court judge. So it's not just that simple to convert a Hindu, especially it's all, why I'm just using the minority Hindu over here, because the targets of forced conversions are Hindus, they're not Parsis, not Christians. And this area, one has to remember, is a very backward area. 0% literacy, I think, 0%. And even the people over there, the majority, they have no relevance for law also. So, you know, caring about the minority is the last thing on their mind. So I'm trying to bring the age hurdle over there, and I'm trying to bring the witness. She has to be a high court judge or a first class magistrate. Now there's a question which might be going in your mind. Why not stop the forced conversion? Why bring in hurdles? Why not bloody well stop the damn thing? I hope I'm using the right words. Because that's how I use it. You know, why not stop? The Muslims I've sat with, they say invitation to Islam is sending invitation to a non-Muslim. You have to do it as a Muslim. Then bringing into your own fold, it says in the book. So I can't go to the assembly and say no, the word is wrong. You know, one cannot do that. So I'm trying to bring some hurdles in the conversion process. That's one bill. The other bill is job quotas, Mr. Kulkarni. Job quotas for minorities are not there for the private sector. For the public sector is bound to keep 5% non-Muslims. Even that is not being cared about. But now I'm trying to bring from the industry I belong from the private sector, that I should be also be forced. I do have a religious minority in my group of companies, but as a choice I have it, not as an authoritative order from the government. So I'm trying to bring that the private industry, the service industry, must employ 5% religious minorities. That's the second one. The third one is, I'm working on a Hindu Marriage Act, Mr. Kulkarni. Right now, the marriage of a Hindu boy or a girl is not recognized by the municipality, by the government, not by this. So, they get victims of harassment because the government does not issue them a marriage certificate. And it's surprising that why is a Parsi doing this now in 2014 or 15? Why didn't the Hindu legislators sitting in the assembly, why didn't they raise this 20, 30 years ago? So I don't have an answer to that. But right now I'm working on, I should rather use on this bill, it's we, coupled with 2-3 more Hindu MLAs, to work on to bring some kind of registration of the Hindus with the government department. So they need this registration at the time of death, division of property, and other, you need the marriage to be. And the fourth bill that I'm working on is the hate material. Basically it's targeted against the Hindus, not against the Parsis and not much against the Christians, is the hate material that we see in the classrooms, in the syllabus, against the Hindu gods or the Hindu religion or whatever. So I'm trying, it's a hard sell. The forced marriage and the job quota and the Hindu marriage, I can hopefully see happening, but the taking out the hate material from the syllabus, if a 4-year or a 3-year old is told Hindus are bad, India is our enemy for all time's sake, so naturally you get people like Zakal and Lakhri and all those types of people. So these are the places I'm trying to work, and I'm also trying to get the father's late Qaid-e Azam speech. I'm trying to bring it into, not in the constitution probably, but trying to bring it in the school syllabus. because again going to the constitution, he had to face a lot of criticism. But instead of taking that route, I am trying to have the same thing, same speech of 11th August 47 to be put into political science where the students are made to read it. That is something I am working on. And this is what I am doing. And there are 10 seats in the, I should have said this before, there are 10 seats in the National Assembly. Majority is with our government, the ruling party. I think six are with the PMLN, and there's one with the PPP, Benazir's party, one with Imran Khan's party, one with MQM's party, and one with Maulana Fazlur Rehman's party also, the right wing. They've got a Christian woman over there. So there are 10 seats all in all. And the census is also due, so we don't exactly know how much minority, is it 3%? I think the number has grown from 3 to 4-5%. But since there's not been a census since 1998, so it's been 15 years. So we are also trying to bring the census about. But again, the problem comes down that the army and the administration, they're all busy fighting a war. Whether it's a right war or a wrong war, that's not for me to judge or for me to comment. But you need a big apparatus, as Mr. Kulkarni will bear with me, that for census you need army and you need the whole, whole big setup to count 200 million plus people. So again, the mind or the attention or the focus is not census. Because why we are all emphasizing on census, the minorities at least, is that we need to, the funds are still 1998 census, when the minority was probably really a minority. So right now, other than the Parsis, unfortunately, all minorities are growing. The Hindus are growing, the Christians are growing, their bhais over there, the Kalashi people are growing. It's only the Parsi people who don't believe in... Exactly. So these are things I'm working on. I've given you a small introduction to the National Assembly also. It's a house of 346 people and 10 are minorities, and that's all I wanted to talk about from what I'm doing, and I'd be more than happy to take questions if you have anything regarding the how minorities are treated. You're welcome to throw any questions. Thank you.